In this video, I will be showing you how to use Rendair in conjunction with Revit for each step of the design process in order to brainstorm ideas and get quick visualization. Speed and efficiency of this AI tool is really important in tight deadline situations. We will start with a simple text prompt to get us inspired, and then we will be using that inspiration with a Revit mass image to see our vision. Then we will use a complete 3D model to get much more powerful renderings, and we will be testing out different seasons to get the full picture. I will show you how to make changes where necessary, and finally we will be generating a 4K image and even a video from a still image. Let's go! To access Rendair, please visit the link in the cards above and also down in the description of this video. You can easily create an account and start working. For Balkan Architect viewers only, there is a discount code. Use Balkan Architect 10 to get 10% off. Also, we have a free 3-month giveaway for one person that comments on this video what they would like to use Rendair for. Just make sure to have your email or other contact information in your YouTube account so we can contact you and give you your free 3-month trial. The giveaway ends at the end of this week, so make sure to comment quickly. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Rendair. And here we are inside of Rendair. Now you can see I'm logged into my account and I have the pro plan. So let's get started. And first I want to show you this community feature. So that's this first tab here. We have the community creations. And this is where everybody that's using Rendair can share their own creations. This is really useful in order to get inspired or just to see what's possible. For example, this looks really good. So this is what the kind of original was, and this is what Rendair turned it into, which is quite cool. So you can just go through this and see basically what's possible. We also have some video tutorials that you can check out if you want. Now let's get started and let's move to the Create tab here. And I just want to get inspired for the beginning of this process. I'm working on a project and I just want to use the text to render in order to get some inspiration and also an image that we can use for reference for later stages of the process. So first, for the image style, we can pick out any of these. I'm just going to go with realistic because it makes most sense for this project. And then this is the most important part, describing the scene. I'm just going to say that I want this to be an office building, glass and stone facade. I have it, let's say, 4 stories tall, and also I have some trees and parking around it. Also, we will be adding some keywords just to help out the process. So I want the view direction to be at street level. This is an office building. Then here we can see what we can add. Let's say this will be modern, and then I want a glass curtain wall. I want stone. Let's go with sunny daylight and with soft lights. And now I'm just going to click on add. So we have that. The creativity, let's just leave it at 60. Now for the aspect ratio, I'm just going to go with the 16:9 to fit my screen. And then for the number of generations, because I want to get multiple options to choose from, I'm just going to go with 4, and then I'm going to hit generate. Now this process of generating images on average takes anywhere from 10 to 30 seconds, so I'm just going to wait and see what we get. And this is the end result. Okay, this looks really cool. We can scroll down and we can see, okay, so it starts from here. This is one that it offered us. This is another one. Okay, this looks really cool. We have this one. And we have this one. So as you can see, they're very, very different. So we can pick out the style that we want, or we can obviously run it again if we choose so. So I'm going to pick this one. I think it looks probably closest to what I'm trying to do, or even this one. Yeah, perhaps let's go actually with this one. So now what I'm going to do next is just close out of this. And the next stage in the process is to try to combine this inspirational image that we've generated with our actual model. So let's now switch to sketch to render, And here we need to drop in an image for our sketch. So I'm just going to upload that. Here we have this simple mask that I've created in Revit in the masking environment. So I'm just going to open that up. For the image strength, I do want to keep the kind of the proportions and what this looks like. So I'm just going to go to something like 70 for the image strength. Then moving forward, the scene description, I'm just going to leave it as is, and the creativity is going to stay at 60. However, we're going to be adding in a reference image. So we can go here to add, and instead of uploading an image, which is something that we can do, I'm going to select from my previous creations. So I can just select this, and then I can say, okay, so I want this image, the one that I preferred, and then I can just say confirm. So it's going to load in that image. And here for the strength, we can just leave it at 30. I think that's fine. And for the number of generations, again, I'm going to go with 4 just so we can pick from multiple images. And then I'm just going to hit generate. And again, we're just going to wait for 10 to 30 seconds on average. And here are the results. So let's just start from the first one. So we have this one. Okay, this looks really cool. I like this part here with the balconies and this indentation. That looks kind of interesting. Okay, this one looks also really, really cool. This one looks nice, but yeah, this one's okay too. I think I prefer perhaps this one or... No, I think I'm going to go with the first one. Yeah, I really like this one. Here, what you can do is you can go here to the compare option, and then it's going to allow you to compare the original one, what you've entered as the reference image, and then what you get. So you can see it really follows the lines and everything quite nicely. So yeah, that's what we have. So I'm just going to turn off this compare, and now let's take it one step further. So I'm just going to close out of this image. I'm just going to remember that this is the one that I want to use. And now let's move to 3D base to render. The reason why I'm doing this is because I have a more advanced model now. So I'm just going to get rid of this image and drop in a new image. Again, I'm just going to be uploading an image. So I have this hidden line view from Revit. So this is how my model is progressing so far. So I just want to use that image. We're keeping the same prompt, and then for the reference image here, I'm just going to get rid of this one and add another image, which is going to be the one that we have seen previously, the one that I really like, which is this one. So I'm just going to confirm that, and there we go. Again, for the number of generations, let's go with 4, just so we get more to choose from. As you have seen before, it's really powerful to have many different things to pick from. And then let's hit the generate and wait for a few seconds. And this is what we get. Okay, this looks cool. So let's start off from the first one. So we have this one. We have this one. Okay. We have this and this. Okay, this is really difficult to choose from. They all look so good. So I think... Yeah, I think I prefer this one. Yeah, I like the curvature here in the stone. It's, yeah, okay, this one looks really, really good. So I prefer this one. And then again, let's just compare it with the previous one to see what it did. So yes, as you can see, this is what Rendair did with our image. Okay, this is really cool. Okay, so I'm definitely moving forward with this one. So the next step is going to be to test out some render variations. So obviously here we can see what the building looks like right now, but let's see what it looks like in winter, for example. So let's go to render variation. I'm just going to get rid of this image, drop in one of the previous creations, which is going to be, I think, this one. Yeah, this is the one that they like. Okay, so for the image strength, let's go with 65. Now here for the image variation, see we can pick out from multiple styles. Now I'm just going to go with the winter style. I want to see this in the snow, what that looks like, and it's going to change the prompt for me. So that's really useful. And then for the add-on reference image, I'm just going to get rid of that one. I don't want it to mess with my snow image. And for this one, for snow, because it's not going to be changing it all that much, I'm just going to go with 3 generations and just see what we get. So let's hit generate and see the results. And this is the result. Okay, this looks cool. So let's see all three. So this is the first one. Okay, this is the second one. See, we're really splitting hairs here. There's not much difference. So we can just pick out that one that we prefer, which, yeah, let's go with the final one. I think this one is the best one, and I'm just going to use that one moving forward. Now, I would like to change it a little bit. I would like to add a car here, perhaps add a little bit of color with that car. So let's go and hit Edit Render and go to Select and Modify, and that's going to move me to the Edit window here. So what that means is now we can start editing this image. So let's click on edit, and then we have the brush tool. And with the brush tool, we can just start drawing here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to mark out a spot here at this side of the building, perhaps like that. Okay, and now I'm just going to tell Rendair to place a red car here. So I'm just going to hit done. What this will do is, you're just going to notice here in a second, it's going to appear over here, yeah, that markation. So it knows that to apply the change over here exactly where I've specified it. Now I'm just going to say add a red car, or let's just go red car here. Perfect. Then for creativity, let's let it go wild, and I'm just going to go with one generation, and yeah, that should be it. So let's hit generate and see the result. And this is what we get. So, okay, this looks really cool. It added a car here. And yeah, as I said, just a bit of color. I think it improves the image quite a bit. Now, this looks like, I think it looks like the Mercedes-Benz SL 350 gull wing. So this is a really, really popular classical car from the 50s. It's one of my favorite cars. So it's really cool that it can kind of read my mind and what they like. So yeah, okay, I really like this. We can also compare it to what we had before. See? Okay, yeah, it looks a lot better now with this. Okay, so let's now move it to the next step, which is to generate a more kind of high quality image, or to actually upscale it to 4K. So let's go here to upscale and enhance. For the size, I'm just going to go to 4x. For image strength, let's go to 100. For the texture, let's go to 50. Now we have this fix people option, and that's in case you have people that can kind of look weird when you enhance the image. So you just need to check this if you want those people to look kind of more human, I guess. For the number of generations, let's just go with one. We're just kind of enhancing it, so that's okay. And let's hit generate. And here we have the 4K image. Now I'm going to download it right away so I can see it. And yeah, this is what it looks like on my computer. You can see if I zoom in, it's really a high quality image. So it looks really, really good. So yeah, that's the 4K that we've just generated. Now, finally, for kind of the cherry on top, I'm going to show you how to create a video from this. So we actually have the function where we can drop in our image. So I'm just going to choose the final image which we have created, and we're going to be actually turning this into an animated video. So as soon as the image loads in, we then need to adjust the crop. So I'm quite happy with this current crop as it is. So I'm just going to click on crop. Obviously, you can zoom in if you want. I don't want to. So now we can describe the scene. I'm going to start off with some motion presets. So I'm just going to make this wide shot and zoom in, click add, and then also I'm going to say pan to the left, for example. Okay, then I'm going to hit generate here. As you can see, it says 25 credits. With the pro plan, you get by default 375 free credits. And this is enough for 15 videos, which is great. And then obviously later on, you can get more credits if necessary. Now I'm just going to hit generate, and it's going to start generating our video. And here's our video. It has actually generated it quite quickly. I'm really impressed. And now let's check it out. So I'm just going to hit play. Okay, this is really cool. It kind of added to the back side of the building. It completely panned around. It looks very, very natural for an AI video. So I'm really, really impressed with this. Now, these videos is something that you can use to really impress your clients. It's going to be something that you can kind of add on as part of your deliverable, and I think it's really, really powerful. So there we go. That's how you can generate video rather quickly with Rendair. Now, as I mentioned in the beginning, if you want to check out Rendair for yourself, the link is up in the cards above and also down in the description of this video. Make sure to use the Balkan Architect 10 discount code to get a 10% discount, and also make sure to participate in the giveaway. So leave a comment just below this video telling us what you would like to use Rendair for, and by the end of this week we're going to pick out one of the commenters, and they're going to get a 3-month free trial for Rendair. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.